What do you see?
I feel like I'm in space or just above everything.
Mm-hmm. I feel like
I'm still kind of, I'm still the same.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So we can continue floating through there. Let's see what you can find out in space. What can you find out there?
Colors.
Colors, very good. Tell me what colors you see.
I see green.
Mm-hmm. I see green. What else? But
like a light, a white border around the green.
Beautiful.
And darkness beyond that.
Let's focus in on this green and see what it is. Allow yourself to get closer to this green. What do you feel from it?
It's air to its space.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel like it's solid. I feel like I can see through it.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Tell me more about this. Describe it fully.
It's just space.
Mm-hmm. Just space.
But no stars, no.
That's good. That's okay. But let's focus on the other things that we can see. Tell me what else you could see.
Just the same.
Just the same. So, this thing in front of you that has this green, let's find out more about it. Can you get closer to it? Zoom in on it and have you get closer to this thing.
It's a place.
It's a place. Mm-hmm. Get even closer.
I feel my heart beating as I get closer.
Mm-hmm, good, enjoy that. Let's see what it is. What is this place? What happened?
As I get closer, I feel like resistance.
Resistance. So we need to find out what this place is. Because obviously there's something there that we need to take care of. Let's find out what this green place is. You're totally safe. I'm right with you.
It's a portal.
It's a portal. Very good. So what does this portal look like?
A hole.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I want to go in there.
Mm-hmm. What do you get from this place?
Uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable. So let's see what happens as you're watching this. Tell me what happens next.
It's swirling.
It's swirling. In which direction is it swirling?
Oh. Left to right.
Left to right. Very good. Just watch it as it swirls. And tell me if you feel any movement in yourself getting closer to it.
I feel the energy from it.
Mm-hmm. You feel the energy. What kind of energy are you feeling from it?
Uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable. Mm-hmm.
And now it's lighter.
Lighter. What color is it now?
It's bright.
Mm-hmm.
It's greenish. Goldish.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Very good.
But it's not swirling now. Now it's just there.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't feel that way anymore.
How does it feel now?
I feel not afraid, but uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. So let's go even deeper to see what's keeping you in that uncomfortable state. We want to find the origin of that so we can help you today. Let's find out why you're so uncomfortable with this.
Something's there.
Something is there.
Not somebody.
Something.
It's a feeling.
Mm-hmm. So let's get to the bottom of it. Let's find out what it is that's there. What is this something? What does it look like or feel like?
Like a blob.
Like a blob. What color is this blob?
Green.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
It's looking at me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm looking, but I don't have a body.
Mm-hmm. That's okay.
I'm just there.
Mm-hmm.
With my mind.
I'd like you to see if you can tell what you look like there. Do you feel like you have any color or any pattern?
I feel green.
Green. Mm-hmm. What color green?
Like a lime.
Like a lime green. And that's your signature, that green? That's who you are?
Yes. I'm like the other thing.
That's mm-hmm. there. But you say you feel uncomfortable mm-hmm. with it. Let's find out why you feel uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. What is this green thing that's looking at you? Connect with it telepathically, and let's find out what it is.
He says it's me.
Mm-hmm. What else? How do you feel about that?
I feel like I'm like jello.
Mm-hmm. Like jello.
Yeah, that's kind of looks like a jello.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel when he says that you're the same? How does that make you feel?
I don't understand.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out. Ask him more.
He says to watch. Need to watch.
You need to watch?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What's he watching?
He's looking through a window.
He's looking through a window? What kind of window is this?
We're inside.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I think a ship.
You're inside a ship?
Mm-hmm. He's looking at the window.
What does this ship look like?
Round.
Mm-hmm, a round ship. What color is this ship?
Silver.
It's the same color?
Silver.
Silver. Mm-hmm.
It's round. And he's sitting at the control.
Mm-hmm.
And he's telling me to look mm-hmm. and to watch, to see. But I don't know what to see. I just see black.
Mm-hmm. What does this blob look like at this control?
He looks like me.
Mm-hmm.
And he has one eye.
One eye. Mm-hmm.
And he's always translucent.
And translucent. What do you look like?
The same.
The same. Mm-hmm. Do you have a body in this place? On this ship?
I can see through it.
Mm-hmm. Describe for me what it looks like. Does it have arms or legs?
No. Just sits on the ground.
Sits on the ground?
And he moves like jello.
Mm-hmm. And it has one eye?
Mm-hmm. But it has hands.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's touching the controls.
Mm-hmm. See what it is that you need to look at. What are you being told to look at?
A light.
A light?
Like a bright.
What color is this light?
Bright.
Bright. Why are you being directed to look at this light?
is others.
There's others. Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
We have to find them.
Mm-hmm. Are they lost?
I feel like they were taken.
They were taken. Tell me more. Tell me the story of how they were taken.
It was a trip.
It was a trip. Mm-hmm.
And there was a pole, a big pole.
Mm-hmm.
And it sucked them, the ships.
And it sucked the ships?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. How many ships were there?
About 10.
Where was this big pole?
In the sky.
Mm-hmm.
It sucked them.
It sucked them. And where did it take them?
We don't know.
Why were you not sucked with it?
We were watching.
We were watching. So tell me what happens now. How do you know that these are your companions?
They went first.
Mm-hmm.
We're looking for a new place.
Mm-hmm. Where did you come from?
I came from another planet.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about this planet. What does it look like?
Not there no more.
What happened to it?
It burned.
It burned? Who burned it?
Something hit it.
Was it on purpose or was it a war?
It's an accident.
An accident.
Mm-hmm. A meteor.
A meteor hit it? Did you lose people there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. A lot of them or a few?
All of them.
All of them. So who were the ones that escaped?
The ones who went on the trip.
You went on the trip before this happened?
Mm-hmm.
So are you lost without a planet now?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you
feel?
Scared. Mm-hmm. Let's find out why.
Perfect.
Tell me what's happening.
We don't know where to go. Alone.
Mm-hmm.
We don't want to go in the hole.
You don't want to go in the hole?
No.
Is this hole the tube?
Mm-hmm. No, it's a hole.
You said it was a portal?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why are you afraid of this portal?
I don't know where we're going. Know if these others will hurt us.
Mm-hmm.
We're nice.
You're nice. Mm-hmm. So let's find out what happens now. Advance to see.
We were the watchers.
You were the watchers? Mm-hmm. What were you watching?
But we didn't see it. We were watching.
You're watching as it happened?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't see it till it was too late.
And what could you have done?
Moved.
Could have moved.
Moved the planet.
Could you move a planet?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What is your planet made out of?
Like us.
Mm.
It's soft.
Mm-hmm. It is energy also?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Translucent like you?
Mm-hmm. We can see everything.
We can see everything on the planet?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
But we didn't see that.
Why is that? What was different about this time?
It was fast.
Mm.
And it sent everybody everywhere.
It sent everybody everywhere. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Tell me about the ship that you're on. What does the ship look like?
It has its windows all around, glass all around.
Mm-hmm.
Metal between the windows.
Mm-hmm.
It's dome and rounded on the bottom. And there's two of us in there.
Mm-hmm.
And we're moving. He's controlling it.
Mm-hmm. How does he control it? What does he do?
There's two levers. And he has two. He's using two of them at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
To hold us where we are, so mm-hmm. we don't move.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to go in. I don't want to. I don't want to go in there.
Who is he to you?
My comrade.
Your comrade.
Comrade.
Mm-hmm. Is he superior to you?
He knows more than me.
Mm-hmm.
He's not afraid. He thinks we should go. I don't think we should
mm-hmm.
go.
Do you consider yourself young or old?
No. There's no,
no age?
Mm-hmm.
You're equal?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let's see what happens next. Tell me what happens.
He says we're going.
Mm.
Here we go.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what happens. Tell me everything that happens.
We're going through it.
Through this portal?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What does it look like in there?
It feels, it looks. I see light and it feels. It doesn't feel scary
mm-hmm.
in there.
It was scarier on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, very.
What's the inside feel like?
It feels like a tunnel, and it feels, it's light.
Mm-hmm. What color is the light?
It's like a greenish.
Mm-hmm.
We're just going in now. He says it's good, it's good.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel any movement in your ship?
I feel like we're gliding through it. Mm-hmm. We're not forced into it.
You're gliding.
Yeah, we're gliding through it.
So it must feel good.
It does.
Mm-hmm.
Better.
Do you feel like you're being pulled or pushed through?
Gliding. His hands are still on the control.
Mm.
It's cold in here, though.
Mm-hmm.
It's cold. He said just for now.
Mm-hmm.
Not to worry.
So what happens after that?
There's a lot of ships there.
A lot of ships. What do they look like?
They're different.
Hmm.
They have. Some of them go fast.
Mm-hmm. Yours don't go fast?
No.
Mm-hmm.
No.
How many ships would you say are out there?
A lot. Hundreds?
Hundreds.
It's cold here, though. Very cold.
Mm-hmm.
He said, we're not going to freeze.
It seems like your comrade is pretty funny.
He is.
He tries to keep things light.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
He looks not scared.
Is he helping you get along?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He says he won't look at me.
Why is that?
Because I look funny. He says, I'm shaking like jelly.
He's quite a comedian.
He's funny.
Mm-hmm. And he looks the same.
Yes.
With one eye.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk about what you see out there. What's this place like?
It's, everybody's just floating in the ships. They're all on the ships.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody is out of them. It's not a planet.
Mm-hmm.
It's space. But they're all there.
Mm-hmm. And you say that there's different shapes.
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the shapes that you see?
This one like house, but it's real tall mm-hmm. in the middle. My house is round. It's tall.
Mm-hmm.
But not very wide, but
tall.
Tall.
Mm-hmm. Can you see any windows in these ships?
Yes, that one has. That's all glass.
Mm-hmm.
And I see a yellow person in there, like a beam, like a light, but it's not a light. It's something.
What does he look like?
He's like light, but he's not a form of a human. He's like a stream of light, like mm-hmm. Like you know what the fireworks, the candlestick look like,
mm-hmm.
like that in yellow. He's just the light that like that.
Okay.
Orangey yellow.
Mm-hmm. What else do you see in the other ships?
There's one that's square.
Square one. Mm-hmm.
And they're walking around.
Where are they walking?
In their ship, I can see them.
They have windows?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What do they look like?
They're tall. They're blue.
These are two tall people?
Mm-hmm.
Or do they look humanoid?
No, but they walk.
They walk.
They walk.
Mm-hmm. What do they look like?
They have arms. Thanks. But I don't see their features,
mm.
but I see their blue.
They're blue.
And they're upright.
Mm-hmm. Are there many of them?
I see two of them.
Okay. Let's see what else you see in this area.
Zebras.
What do you see?
Zebras.
Tell me about that.
They're standing now.
They're standing. Mm-hmm.
I don't see their ship, I just see them.
Hmm. How are they standing there?
They're talking to each other.
Mm-hmm.
What needs to be done?
Mm-hmm.
I think they're important there.
Mm-hmm. Describe what they look like.
They're striped.
Mm-hmm.
And they have zebra heads.
Mm-hmm.
But they talk.
But they talk.
Mm-hmm.
So they look like normal zebras, but they're just talking.
And they're upright.
And they're standing up.
Yes, they're not on all fours.
Okay.
And they don't have tails.
Do they have fingers?
No.
No.
They have hooves.
They have hooves. Interesting. Are these zebras important?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Are they some sort of leadership?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, they want everybody together.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out. What are they talking about? Connect with them telepathically, the way that they communicate. Let's find out what this place is and what they're saying.
They want all the ships to not line up to coordinate that they're all around.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to address them. The big one.
Mm-hmm.
One is a little bigger than the other, and he's important, more important. He has a badge.
Mm-hmm. He has a badge on
mm-hmm.
him.
Mm-hmm. And he's telling the other one has a clipboard.
Hmm.
And he's telling him how to get the ships all aligned and coordinated so that he can speak to everybody and tell them all together, They must be together, everybody together.
Mm-hmm. Is that why the portal was created?
Yes.
To bring you there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So everybody heard the call?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what happens now.
He says we're in danger.
We're in danger.
And now I feel it.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what this danger is all about.
Things are crashing.
Things are crashing?
We need to bond together, be together.
Mm-hmm.
We need to help each other. They have to save them.
They have to save them? Mm-hmm. Who are they saving?
All of the different people, all of the different... I don't want to call them aliens because I'm one.
Mm-hmm.
All of us, all of them. We're all stuck there. None of us have homes anymore.
I see.
And we have to live together and help each other from distinction. That's what we need to do.
Mm-hmm.
They're the only two zebras left.
Mm. So let's find out what happened to all of the other planets. What happened to them?
They're being hit.
They're being hit?
By things, by... The planets are breaking up. And they're hitting other planets. The pieces are falling and hurting. And... Most of them didn't get away. They didn't get out. It just happened real fast. They didn't know. So many.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out what happens to all of you. Close that scene and open the scene to see where you are now living. Where are you?
We're in our ships.
You're in our ships?
In our ships?
Mm-hmm.
There's a problem. I don't know what it is, but there's a problem.
Mm-hmm. With your ship? Or with something?
With everybody, with everything.
Mm-hmm.
With the plan.
What happened with the plan?
It doesn't work. We all breathe different.
Mm-hmm.
We all have different... We're different.
Mm-hmm.
But we have to stay together.
Well, each planet was created for the beings that lived on it, like your own.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the new plan? Earth. What's about Earth that's different?
We could all live on Earth.
How can you live on Earth if you have different ways of breathing and living and looking?
It's a dark Earth. It's an Earth that doesn't have light.
It's a dark Earth. Okay. Is it in a different dimension?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like Earth, though.
Mm-hmm.
But the water's black.
Tell me more.
I don't see water. I don't see green. But there's an energy.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes from the ground. It comes from the Earth. We can all survive there.
Okay.
He says they can build from our ships what we need to survive, all of us. But they may They may not. The zebras may not.
Why is that?
They don't have a ship.
Mm.
We see them through our ship.
Mm-hmm.
They're just like in space. They're just there.
Mm-hmm.
But they're standing. They're not floating. They're talking. It's like.
Mm-hmm. What's special about these zebras?
Strong.
Mm-hmm.
They're smart. They know.
What do they know?
They know how to survive. They know how to build. They know how to keep us at peace.
Mm-hmm.
And not afraid of each other.
Mm-hmm.
We look to them for the guidance.
So let me know what happens with Earth. Advance the scene.
We go.
Mm-hmm.
Going down. It's a weird feeling.
Why is that?
Because we're not controlling the ship now.
How are you going to Earth then?
They're guiding us there.
Mm-hmm.
All of us, all the ships.
Are being guided.
We're being guided down.
Mm-hmm. Who's guiding you?
The earth.
Mm-hmm.
The energy.
Are you able to connect with the earth's consciousness?
It's too weak.
Too weak? Okay, so tell me what happens next.
We're coming down. There's a feeling of nobody speaks. Everybody's quiet. We're waiting. We just don't know. They're not scared. I'm not scared. I feel good about it.
How do you know where to land on this earth?
It takes us.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out where you land.
We're on a ball right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a dome.
Mm-hmm.
There's a horizon. There's orangey lights there. It's like an orange glow.
Mm-hmm.
But we're not there. I feel like we're like sitting on top of the world.
Mm-hmm.
But we can see that. It's very peaceful here. It's very nice here.
What is this? What is this gray earth? Is it a different type of earth? Is it separate than the other earth?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's just energy. It's only energy. Mm-hmm. There's no people.
No people.
No people.
But it belongs to the other earth too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's very strong energy. It pulsates in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
And the energy is fire. I see the fire in it.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens once you land on this. Tell me what happens next.
We're opening the ship. Goes up the top. My friend goes first.
How do you get out of this ship?
wobble.
You wobble?
We wobble.
Mm-hmm.
The steps went down like a Bennett stairs, like a ramp.
Mm-hmm.
We come down. We can breathe.
Very good.
But there's nothing there. Nowhere. But yet we feel it. We feel that. We feel the energy of the earth. We feel we can live.
Mm-hmm.
But there's nothing there.
Right.
We don't eat.
You don't eat?
No.
How do you get energy yourself?
From our planet.
But now?
Our new planet.
Mm-hmm. Do you absorb the energy of the earth? Is that what you do?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So you don't need any nutrition, any sustenance?
No.
Okay.
We don't sleep either.
Mm.
We just be. Mm-hmm. We're just there.
Mm-hmm.
But we have knowledge, or we have... I don't see a brain because I can see through.
Mm-hmm.
They say we hold it in our outer skin.
Mm-hmm.
Is where our knowledge is, how we know things. We feel it. We hear it.
You hear it in your thoughts?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And that Earth is telling us that we're okay, and we're going to be okay, all of us.
Mm. Does the Earth have any type of male or female energy? Can you tell?
I feel it's one.
It's one?
It's just one.
Mm-hmm. One gender?
Yeah, but now I heard Mother Earth. I just heard Mother.
Mm-hmm.
So, Mother.
Mother.
She's going to help us.
Wonderful. So let's close the scene now. Let's advance to another scene in that same lifetime when something important is happening. Advance the scene and tell me what's going on.
We have a compound.
You have a compound?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And we're all there. And it's funny, but we all can communicate with one another through vibration, through energy,
mm-hmm.
from the earth.
So all of you look different?
We're all different.
Mm-hmm.
yes, we're all different. Some of us, some have a lot of color,
mm-hmm.
a lot. This one I'm looking at, I think it's female. She has all pink,
mm-hmm.
and like a horn on the top of her head. And but it's her mouth, it's not a one.
Mm.
But she's very, she talks a lot.
Is this compound where you're watching, is it indoors or outdoors?
We're all outside now, mm-hmm. We're all outdoors.
And what does the planet actually look like? You had said before it was gray.
Yes.
What does it look like now?
It's the same.
Same.
It feels like the air, and it's like night.
Mm-hmm.
It's always night. It's never day.
Mm-hmm.
And it feels like temperature-wise, it just feels the same all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And they have to keep it at one place. That's why we all can be there together, because it accommodates everybody's different body temperatures and body,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Different bodies.
Yes. So what happens when you're on this compound now? What is your life like? What's your purpose?
I don't know. Just all there right now.
Mm-hmm.
Coexisting.
Okay, so close that scene now. Let's go to another scene, advance it forward to when something significant is happening in that lifetime, something that impacts you. Where are you?
We're still there, mm-hmm. but it's lighter now.
It's lighter. Tell me about that.
The light is coming.
Mm-hmm. Where is it coming from?
The other side of the earth. It's like if I look to my left, it's bright. If I look to my right, it's still dark.
Mm-hmm.
It's coming over us.
Where do you think this light is coming from?
The sun.
Mm-hmm.
They said we have to go. We may have to go.
Why is that?
We may be too close.
To the sun?
Yes. Everybody's not... They're worried. They're mm-hmm. not happy anymore. We were all good. We were all living together. But we weren't doing anything purposeful.
Mm-hmm. You were just existing?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But it's time to go. It's because we didn't want to go. Everybody liked it there.
Mm-hmm. So where are you going to go to next?
We don't know because the zebras aren't there anymore.
What happened to them?
They stopped talking.
Mm. What happened to them?
I think they're gone.
Mm-hmm.
We have no leader.
Let's see what happens next. Allow yourself to go through that scene and see what happens.
We want to follow each other, but we don't know if we could. Some want to stay and see what happens.
Mm-hmm. Who is that?
That's what she was saying before, the one with the big mouth.
Mm-hmm. She's going to stay?
Why should we go? Why? We don't know. We know this. What's the sun? Sun. But they weren't calling it the sun. The light. She calls it the fire.
The fire. Mm-hmm.
What do we do? But she makes people nervous.
Mm-hmm.
Not people. Others.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know.
Let's find out what you do. Advance the scene until you find out and are doing what you wanted to do. Where do you go?
We're leaving.
Mm-hmm.
Me and my friend are leaving. Risky. Others said they'll follow us. But others are staying. They feel what's there. They know. And they know they can live for it as long as, until they know what happens, whether it happens or it doesn't. But the unknown of flying away scares them even more.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's because we don't have a leader. It's like we're all, we feel like children.
Mm-hmm. What do you think is going to happen to the earth when they stay there?
We don't think it's good. We think that's why everything is dark like that, that it burned from the sun.
Mm.
That's why we're going to leave, because it's just earth, it's just ground. There's nothing.
Mm-hmm.
It's the earth and you, the energy and you. We're afraid to stay. We don't want to get burnt up.
Mm-hmm.
We're leaving. He says, "So where do you want to go?" I tell him. I trust him.
Okay. So close that scene and get to their destination.
You found others like us.
How were they?
They were floating still. We're following them now.
Is there a leader? Where does he take you?
We're going to a new planet. It looks nice.
What does it look like?
It looks light. It looks like there's other stuff there. I can see. I see water.
What color is this water?
It's blue. A lot of mountains, a lot of peaks. I see peaks.
What is this planet called?
Rayon.
What's it called?
Rayon.
Rayon?
Rayon.
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 Does anybody live on this planet?
My friend says we do. It's our new home.
Is it very large or a small planet?
It's a big planet. The others followed us. The ones that followed us, they'll be with us too.
Is the atmosphere okay in Rayon?
They say yes. More came than I thought. More followed us.
So you're populating it now?
Yes.
Very good.
Yeah, so everybody's talking now. They all talk to each other. Not through vibration. They can speak.
How do they speak?
I hear them.
What do they say?
They're very happy. They're happy. They have a home. Some of them haven't seen light, so they like that.
This planet has light? It has an atmosphere?
You know who's there?
Who's there?
The lady
with the horn?
Yes.
She's there. She made it there?
She made it. She had to leave, she said. Everybody left. They had to leave. It was hot. She's sorry she didn't follow us and gave us a hard time.
How did she find you?
The stream. We left the stream behind.
So people can follow
yes.
you?
Yes.
Like a trail?
Exactly. A white one. And it has glitter in it.
Beautiful.
They found us.
What is the atmosphere on this planet?
I feel like it's oxygen.
Does it have any other life forms on it? You had said there was mountain peaks. What else is there?
There's caves.
Caves?
That's where we go. We go in the caves now. But there's no people. I see a pile now of wood though. There's once a fire in the cave.
A pile of wood?
That was burned already.
Okay.
So some was there. There's a bird in the cave, a big bird.
What does it look like?
Oh, it has a huge beak, big bird. But he's afraid of us. He's hiding.
What color is this bird?
He's white. And he's scared. We're telling him, don't be scared to come out. It's okay.
How tall is this bird?
He's very tall. He's as tall as he's as tall as the opening, like of the cave. But he's not wide. He's tall and thin.
What are his features like?
His knees are bony. His legs are bony. He's messy.
He's messy.
His fur is all messy. His feathers were messy. He thought we were going to hurt him, so he he said he went into the back where it's safe. Safe from what? The element.
The elements? What are the elements like there?
He says they get harsh. That it gets like a wind, a rock.
Wind?
Yeah, but with rocks in it.
Wind, okay. So you can't be above ground?
No.
You have to be underground?
Only sometimes. Mm-hmm. Only when the storms come, he says. Mm-hmm. And that happens at night, always.
Okay. So during the day you could be outside?
Yes.
This planet. Who else is there besides this bird?
Who else is here?
No else. So he's been by himself this whole time?
I'm asking him, who else? There's more birds, he said.
Small birds?
There's more birds.
Oh, more birds. Are they large also?
Yeah, but they got scared when we came. They didn't know what we were. They never saw that before.
So they fled?
Yes.
Did you all land on your spaceships?
We landed in our spaceships, yes. Mm-hmm.
Very good.
But we don't go in them as much anymore since we're on the planet. We're out. We walk around a lot. We test things. We look at things. We're always touching the ground, touching the walls, touching.
Why is the touching?
Everything, the rocks, to feel their vibration, to see if it can hurt us, to see if it can help us, to see if it's alive. A lot of the times we don't know what's alive and what's not.
Are the rocks alive?
Some of them are. Some of them have, I see orange in them, like a copper.
Those are alive?
Inside the rocks. And they're there for a purpose, too.
Let's find out what it is.
They say it's like a radio wave.
A radio wave?
It's like an antenna. It's like a wave. And it picks up from space of other people, other entities. And it warns them.
What is it?
They knew we were coming.
They knew.
But they didn't know what we were.
Does it send out information to the others? Warning?
I hear it's a receiver.
A receiver. So it knows what's coming towards them.
Yes. And we were many. There was never that many. Drifters, he said they get.
Drifters? They're calling you drifters?
That we're not drifters. We live there now. Others that have come have been drifters. Never the magnitude that we came with. So many.
How many do you think are in your group?
There's so many now. It's thousands.
Thousands.
There's many of us. We like it here and they're all coming.
Very good. This planet Rayon. Very good. So let's close the scene and let's go to the last day of your life in that lifetime. Let's go to the end. Tell me where you are.
I'm in my ship.
You're in your ship. Are you by yourself?
Yes.
What are you doing by yourself in the ship?
I know it's my time. I've been here a very long time. I don't vibrate anymore.
You can't vibrate anymore?
No.
How did you lose your vibration?
Just started to get weaker and weaker. On its own, but I've been here for hundreds of years. And the lights are going out.
And as you transition out of that body, I want you to think back at your entire lifetime.
Sad.
Every lifetime has a purpose and a lesson. What was the lesson of your lifetime? an important one.
We're all the same. Mm-hmm. Love everybody enough to judge anyone. Mm-hmm. Because they're different from you. Mm-hmm. We all work together.
We all work together.
Mm-hmm. The same goal. Mm-hmm. Unity.
Was it a good life?
You're happy now. Mm-hmm.
What lesson did you learn that will carry you on?
Oh, God. The unity is not judging. And loving everybody. Mm-hmm. Because they're different. Not in spite of, but because of. Mm-hmm. And understanding. We're all the same. All of us. Mm-hmm. We all have one purpose.
What is that?
It's to help. Mm-hmm. And to be one. The most important is that we were together. We were all so different, so different, so different. Yet we breathe the same. We work the same. We live the same. We did everything as one. A planet of thousands.
Yes.
And our leader was our Earth, was our planet, not a person. Mm-hmm. The whole unit.
Very good. So go ahead and transition away from that lifetime. Allow yourself to float away from that life. That being will find peace. I know that you could have shown Linda many different lifetimes today. And you showed her in detail this life of this jello-looking being. Why did you show her this lifetime?
That it doesn't feel whole in her body. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't love her body. She loved that body, the jello body. Mm-hmm. She loved who she was.
Where was this body?
My body. Mm-hmm.
Where was this jello body? Was it in space? When was this? Was this before, in the future, in the present? When is this happening?
The future.
In the future. What was this gray planet all about? This gray Earth?
To show her even the darkest place can be made beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's only what you see.
It's only what you see.
Mm-hmm. But it's not how it is. It's not always like that. Mm-hmm.
And who were these people that were in her life?
Her
friends. Are they the friends that they have now?
Yes.
Are there any friends in particular that were in her life?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And you say that this is in the future? Mm-hmm. Okay. And they're still living this life now. Are they being influenced by this life in the future?
They don't know it.
They don't know it.
Debbie does.
How is Linda being influenced by this jello life? Does she feel the fears? Does she feel the camaraderie of other people?
Yes. Camaraderie. Mm-hmm. She likes that.
She likes that. Mm-hmm. Having people around. Is that why she has the type of job she does?
Yes, people mm-hmm. like Linda. Mm-hmm.
She gets to meet all sorts of different types of characters.
Yes.
Kind of like all of those space beings.
Yes.
Very good.
They tell me. Mm-hmm. They tell me all the time.
What do they tell her?
You shine. Mm-hmm. You shine, you're always happy, you're always bright. Mm-hmm.
She says she has an attraction to lighthouses, and the lighthouses shine light. What's that attraction about?
She's a beacon.
She's a beacon. Is that a reminder?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What is she supposed to be doing with this beacon?
Spreading the light.
Mm-hmm. Is she doing it?
Yes.
Okay, very good.
The light's blinding me right now.
Mm-hmm.
That's very bright. Mm.
Tell me more.
I'm just blinded right now. The light is very bright.
Mm-hmm. You could tone down the light. You could put sunglasses on.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You didn't show her any past lives. Why is that?
She needs to move out of the past.
She needs to move out of the past.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Does she have any lives that are influencing her now that she needs to move out of?
A few.
She had told me that she seems to have a strong connection with Jesus. Was she in that past life? Mm-hmm. Would you be able to show her that life now?
I am.
Okay, tell her about that. Tell me what she's seeing.
She's feeling.
Mm-hmm.
His love.
Feeling his love.
Yes. He hears me.
Mm-hmm.
He calls me.
He calls you.
And he has called me.
Mm-hmm.
He says sometimes, not to question, that he is. And always will be with me.
Mm-hmm.
I am his child. I am his sister. I am his friend. I am in his heart.
Mm-hmm.
He's mine.
Mm-hmm. Is that why she feels so overwhelmed sometime in church?
Yes.
What's happening in church when she starts crying like that?
He visits with her.
He visits her.
He sits with her.
Uh-huh.
He speaks in her ear.
What does he tell her?
How much he loves me.
How much he loves you.
He says, I'm a good girl.
Mm-hmm.
And it's okay. It's okay to hurt sometimes, Linda. It's okay. It's temporary. It's okay, you're with me.
What else would Jesus like to tell Linda today? She's all ears.
To follow my heart. Follow my path. But I must do so with an open heart and not be fearful. And I have the faith, but I sometimes lose it. I need to keep the faith all the time.
What kind of faith are we talking about?
In the Lord.
In the Lord. Mm-hmm.
I tell him all the time. I put my faith in my life in his hands. And he guides me, so he may guide me.
Mm-hmm.
And I will not doubt. But sometimes I do when I get scared.
What happens when she gets scared? What's she attracting to her?
Darkness.
Mm-hmm.
The darkness likes Linda.
Why is that?
Because she's so bright.
Mm-hmm.
She's very light, she attracts. She attracts from all over Linda.
Mm-hmm.
She has a golden aura.
Mm-hmm.
That can be seen many, 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 many light years, miles.
Mm-hmm.
Distance. They all see Linda. And the dark ones see Linda.
What are the dark ones doing? Because she has survived already 4 different attempts of, I guess, death.
They don't want her to complete her mission.
Mm-hmm. Who tried to drown her when she was a teenager? Mm-hmm. And who saved her?
They pulled me. They pulled me under.
Mm-hmm.
Thomas tried to save her, but they were pushing him away from her. He was crying. He was so scared. He loves Linda so much.
told her it was his life.
Who saved Linda?
A man.
Who did?
A man.
A man. But who's the one who told her to go to sleep?
I did.
Jesus?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why did you tell her to go to sleep?
It wasn't a man.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like a sea creature.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't. It's not pretty like mermaid. But it was a man.
Mm-hmm.
And he was swimming under. And God, Jesus put me in his path. He knew I was coming. He knew what they did. The fish knew what the.
Mm-hmm.
He knew that they pulled me. And they wanted me away.
This man that saved her.
Mm-hmm.
Was this some sort of a merman?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he saw her. He saw her light. And he saw the dog coming for her.
And he saved her?
Yes. He said I sparkled. My legs were sparkly in the water.
Mm-hmm.
And then they got dark.
And then what did he do? How did he save her?
I didn't bump into him. He took me.
Mm-hmm.
He took me from the creature. From the dog creature.
Mm-hmm.
Which was just water.
Mm-hmm.
Dark water.
And then what happened?
He pushed me forward. He swam me forward. Into the arms of the life gods.
Mm-hmm.
And then he swam away.
Very good.
He said, I can't go yet. I have to be here.
Mm-hmm.
Not my time.
Mm-hmm. Very good. What happened when she had that car land on her? Out of the blue, what was that all about?
Darkness again.
Mm-hmm.
She did it. The girl in the car.
Mm-hmm.
She wasn't driving. She turned the wheel on the man that was driving. And brought the car head on.
Mm.
To Linda. And when it picked up speed, it went airborne. We protected Linda.
How did you protect her?
We shielded her.
Mm-hmm.
Michael shielded her.
Mm-hmm.
He was on the hood with me. I was in the car, he was on the hood.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the car flipped off of me. And didn't continue to roll.
And you saved her once again?
Yes, I did.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't her time.
And what about that fall that she had?
The same. The dog did it.
Mm-hmm.
And she was trying to get in my house. She just came back. She was away.
Mm-hmm.
There was ice. She was holding on, though. We made her fall.
What did they want to do?
I wanted to crack my head open. I hid. I passed out.
Mm-hmm.
And I woke up. My heart's beating. I was so scared. I was out in the cold. On the steps, screaming. And that worried me. I jumped the 6-foot fence to get to me. He did it in one leap. He just made me talk and talk and rub my head and talk.
Who sent them there?
He sent the angels.
The angels sent them?
Mm-hmm. And he needed to be the one.
Why is that?
Because I need to see his. I push Al away.
Mm-hmm.
And he loves me so much. So much. His energy is so strong and powerful. sometimes scary. Mm-hmm. It never hurt me, though. Ever. He loves me so much.
What happened to her in the basement when it seemed like she went through a pipe? What was that all about?
Somebody else in the basement.
There was somebody else in the basement?
Yes.
Who was that?
He died.
He died?
He died outside.
Mm-hmm.
In the restaurant he owned.
Mm-hmm. And what happened?
He saved Linda.
He saved her. How did he save Linda? She was supposed to have hit that pipe with her head.
He stood before her.
Mm-hmm.
And he went through the pipe and got behind him.
And so she didn't feel it?
No, it didn't touch her.
Hmm.
She didn't understand. She was very discombobulated when it happened because she turned to energy at that second.
Hmm. Is that something that typically happens to people?
Yes.
If they have help?
Yes.
Good. Is that man from that basement still with her?
Sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
When she goes to the restaurant.
Does he help her? What's his name?
Charlie.
Mm-hmm.
Charlie.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything Charlie would like to tell her today?
He likes me.
He likes her.
I do good. I do well in his bar.
Good.
I used to know he was there. I'd sense him. I'd smell him.
What did he smell like?
Not so good.
Not so good.
No, but I said it was him.
Mm-hmm.
It was him.
Good.
When I saw him every time.
Good. What's Linda's mission this lifetime? What's she supposed to be doing? To heal people.
And to just speak.
And to speak?
Stop being afraid to speak.
Mm-hmm.
Find her voice. And speak. And if they think you're crazy, so what?
You're supposed to be crazy as a bartender, right?
Those are the ones that believe her, though.
Mm-hmm. So is she supposed to minister to those that are drinking at the bar?
That's right. Not put her back to work.
Oh, okay, good. Is that her spiritual path?
Yes.
Okay.
And her clientele.
And her
clientele. Will be all men.
Will be all men.
All older men that she needs to understand.
Why is that she has such issues with men?
They hurt her so much.
Mm-hmm. Why do men hurt her so much? They want her. They want her energy?
Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm.
They want to be happy. And they don't understand why.
What would you recommend now for her as far as dealing with men in her life?
She knows how to use it.
Mm-hmm.
Her energy.
Mm-hmm.
She knows how to use her light. These men look at her like she's a goddess. Because they see a light in her, and they see hope in her, and they see happiness in her. And even though she's older on the outside, she's young.
Mm-hmm.
Spirit is very young and very light. And that's what they see. They only see that. And they feel it when I touch them. They feel it. They feel the energy. They say, it's like a vibration. It's a touch. It gets an energy that goes through them. And they don't talk about it because they don't understand. Some of them do. Some of them tell her what the hell just happened. And she tells them that's the light.
Mm-hmm.
Sharing the light with you. They like it.
Mm-hmm.
They stop shaking, some of them.
Good. So she does therapy on them when they're there?
Yes.
Good. What can she do with the men in her life now?
She has to love them. They love her.
Has to love them?
She puts up a wall for them.
Does she need to put up a wall for something like that?
No. Mm-hmm. No.
Can we break that wall down today?
Yes.
Okay. So let's do that. I'm going to ask Linda to see, visualize that wall that she's built up around her. See that wall that's all around her that she's built up about men? And I want you to tell me what that wall looks like. What's it made out of?
It's like a punching bag, but a punching bag, like a mat is made out of.
Mm-hmm. How thick is this?
It's thick. Mm-hmm. It's about 6 inches thick. Mm-hmm.
Does it have any holes in it?
No.
And how far does it go up?
It goes up high. Mm-hmm. It goes up really high.
Around where?
Really high. I can look up and see sky.
Okay.
But I can't look over the wall.
How does it feel to have this wall around you?
Protected. Mm-hmm. Safe. Mm-hmm. Can't be touched.
But if you have this wall around you, you can't receive anything either.
I don't receive Alex's love. Mm-hmm. Or Al's.
Are you ready to take down that wall today so that you can receive this love?
Yes.
All right. What would you like to use to tear down this wall? What kind of tool would you like to use?
Energy. Vibration.
All right.
I want it to fall away.
So go ahead and start beaming that vibration and light on this wall and tell me what happens as you get rid of it. Is it?
It's falling.
It's falling. Very good.
It's falling.
Mm-hmm. Tell me how that feels in your body as this wall comes down.
Oh. It felt lighter. Mm-hmm. And I feel so unblocked.
Unblocked? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I'd like the archangels now to fill Linda up with their beautiful light. Fill her with love. Because you cannot give what you don't, what you can't receive what you don't give. So fill her with this love and this energy so that now she's able to be able to give that love and receive that love. And tell me how that feels.
Feels beautiful. Feels peaceful.
Wonderful. Let me speak with her higher self again. How does that help?
She feels it.
She feels it. Very good. Very good. Why is it that she was so bullied when she was in school?
She was afraid. Mm-hmm. She was very afraid of everything.
So did that attract the same vibration?
Yes. These girls, they had terrible lives. Mm-hmm. They thought Linda's was good.
They felt like what?
They thought Linda's was good and they wanted to take that from her.
Oh.
She was so pretty, Linda. Her hair was like silk. Mm-hmm. They used to put nuts and gum in it. They heard her. They were jealous of Linda. Mm-hmm. And they knew she was so scared.
So what would you like to tell Linda about these girls? Did she know them in different lives at all?
No. Mm-hmm.
Did she attract them because of her vibration?
Yes.
So what would you like to tell Linda about how people attract bullies to them?
They see it. Mm-hmm. They feel it. They know. They can take advantage of you.
Of the fear?
Yes, because they're fearful. They live terrible lives themselves, and you have to not show your fear and feel compassion.
Feel compassion towards those, for their bullies?
Yes, because they do it because they're weak. Mm-hmm. And even beat up.
I still smiled when I went to school the next day.
Good. Is there anything that she needs to work off of the her karma with these?
No, they these need to.
They need to?
They need to, not her.
Is there anything that we can send them today to begin this healing process, sending them love?
I can do that.
All right, let's send them love. I want Linda to imagine each one of them in front of her and send them all the vibration of love so that no matter what's going on in their life right now, they're going to start changing their vibration with her love. You see them? Go ahead and send them love.
They're sorry.
Can you forgive yourself for participating in this and sending them that energy? Very good.
Yes. They're very sorry for what they did to me.
So go ahead and fill yourself with that vibration of love. So that they can match that now. And now we can see miracles in their life turn around. Send them that miracle of love. And tell me what they look like now.
The grandma's like me. They're happy.
Very good. Very good.
They're smiling at me.
Good. Wonderful. What is the significance of fish in her life? We've had a situation where that merman saved her life underwater. He's part fish. And then she says that a fish healed her breast.
It was a friend.
Who was that?
It was a friend, Goldie. Goldie took the breast cancer away.
Goldie
before
took...
it had a chance to manifest into sorry, she said. That bited me.
Is Goldie a fish?
Yes.
So Goldie bit her breast and took out the tumor?
Yes. Before it became one.
And it said hello.
Yeah.
Was this Goldie?
No.
Is that another one?
There was Sarah. Sarah's a clownfish.
A clownfish?
She has a lot of colors. She's happy.
Why does she have connections with fish?
Because she's a fish.
She's a fish. Where'd she come from?
The ocean. They said the Baltic.
The Baltic.
The Baltic Sea.
What life? What life did she have there?
She was a fish.
She was a fish.
She liked it.
What kind of fish was she?
A big fish.
A big one?
Big one, like a barracuda.
Ah.
But not a barracuda, but big like that. Silver. She was silvery.
What lifetime was this? How long ago?
Very long ago. It says before people.
Okay. Good.
And she has a lot of friends in the water.
In what way?
When she goes to the beach.
Uh-huh.
They come to her. She doesn't know what they do, but they do. They're around her.
Does she eat fish?
Yeah.
How does that affect her karma?
She doesn't know.
Oh, would you like to tell her about that?
Now you know. Is it okay?
Okay?
It's up to you.
It's up to her whether she eats fish or not.
She eats fish or not. She may not want to know.
Okay, now that she knows that she's one of them. Very good. Would you tell her why, when she saw the video 91, she felt so amazed? What happened in that video?
She's met Ari before.
She's met Ari before, the angel?
She knows him.
Mm-hmm. Did they feel familiar?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Very much. She helps her sometimes.
Wonderful.
To make a decision.
To make a decision.
She helps her make a decision. Sometimes it's a very hard time.
Mm-hmm. Ari does?
Linda does.
Linda does.
Ari helps her.
Ari helps her. Very good. So they work together.
Yes.
Very good. So she felt...
I feel her guidance is what I feel.
Wonderful. Good. Would you tell Linda what time she was born?
1:32.
1:32. Very good. A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
A.M. Very good. What's the reason you brought Linda here today?
So she could move forward and stop asking.
Mm.
Questioning herself and just go with the flow.
Mm-hmm.
We guide her every step of the way. She's never alone.
Never alone.
Never alone.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Would you do a body scan of her now, please? What do you find?
Dark in her shoulder blade.
Dark in her shoulder blade. What is that?
It's a black spot.
A black spot. Would you allow me to speak with it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. So I'm going to take my my hand. I'm going to bring it up. Up, 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 up. Good evening. Who am I speaking with today?
No go.
Is that your name?
Right now.
Okay. Are you male or female?
Male.
Why are you there, Nogo?
So she can't be peace. She can't rest if I give her pain.
Ah. And why would you want to give her pain?
Because she wants to go places.
Mm-hmm. And you don't want to go places? Is that it?
I don't want to go.
Oh, why don't you want to go to the light?
I don't want to go. I don't want Linda to go.
Well, she's not going to the light yet.
She meditates to the light.
Oh, I see. And that bothers you.
It hurts my eyes.
Did it hurt your eyes a little while ago?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. No go. Did you ever have a body?
Yes.
What kind of body did you have, male or female?
I was a man.
A man. How old are you, Noko?
My 30s.
30s. And what did they call you in that lifetime?
Marco.
Marco. Can I call you Marco?
Yes.
Marco, how did you lose your body in that life?
I was crippled.
What was?
I was crippled.
You were crippled. Is that why you're in her shoulder?
Uh-huh.
Where were you crippled?
I was my whole body.
Mm. Is it from birth?
No, I was in an accident.
What kind of accident?
Plane.
Mm. In a plane accident?
Mm-hmm.
And what happened? Were you the pilot?
No. It was a day trip and it crashed.
Mm. And you became crippled?
Yes.
So when you lost your body, what happened to you?
I floated.
You floated. And what kind of emotions were you feeling? Mm-hmm. So how did you find Linda?
I saw her.
Mm-hmm. What attracted you to her?
Her bright light.
Her bright light. The one you can't see now.
Mm-hmm.
So why did you go towards her bright light?
She was safe.
Mm-hmm. You felt safe with her?
She doesn't take chances. She doesn't go. She doesn't fly.
Ah. So you didn't want to lose your life again?
Mm-mm.
Well, Marco, the thing is, you already have a life. You never died.
Oh, this is hurting me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I died. I died.
No, you didn't die. Only your body died.
Yes.
If you died, I wouldn't be able to talk to you. Do you realize that? You have consciousness. Consciousness never dies. Marco, inside of you, there's a little light, yourself. It's like a little pilot light. Find it and tell me when you see it. It's there. I want you to feel it, Marco. Look at that light and expand it. Make it bigger and bigger. Bigger and bigger, Marco.
It's like this light you shine in it.
Feel the love of that light. This is where you came from. You came from the light. You're a child of the light. A child of the Creator, which is pure love. As you expand that light within you, you feel that love growing inside of you. You feel that peace. You no longer feel crippled. You feel whole. How does that feel now?
Good.
Good. Would you like more of that? All right. Are you ready to release from her? There's things.
I
know you like her.
She's safe.
She's safe. The light is even safer. I'm gonna ask the angels of the white light to surround you, and I want them to have you feel their safety. Tell me what they feel like.
The light is brighter.
Isn't it nice? Are you ready to let go now and go with them? What would you like to tell Linda? Linda, would you like to tell Marco? Are you okay for him to let you go? Okay. Marco, go ahead and pull from her body all of your darkness that's no longer there. Pull everything out that attached you to her. Cut it all out. Release it, and as you do, you feel yourself floating with the angels. And Archangel Michael's going to take you by the hand and take you right back to home. And tell me who's there. Who do you find?
My mother.
Give her a big hug, Marco. Doesn't that feel good? May the light of the universe accompany you, Marco. Thank you very much. Thank you. Let me speak with her higher self and let me know if there's any other parts of her body that are feeling shadowy, pulsating, anything like that.
Her lower stomach.
Let me pull that up. Let me bring it up, 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 up. Good evening. How long have you been there with her?
Always.
Always. How did you get there?
I was born there.
You were born there with her. Where did you come from?
The light.
The light. So why are you causing her some discomfort there? Were you part of her before?
Yes. It's her.
It's her.
It's her.
So why are you under on that area? Did she cause it any pain at all?
Yes.
Twice?
She says it's not clean.
It's not clean.
Not clean. Yes.
Twice. Is that why she's not feeling clean? Can she forgive herself for that today? Let's talk to the ones that were there.
It's moving.
Let me talk to one of them, please. Good. Who are you? What's your name? Mike? Michael? Michael? Have you been with your mommy all this time?
Yes.
What would you like to tell her? You didn't go.
That's why I'm at least big, and I won't go down. Because I'm here.
You were here all the time, weren't you?
Yes.
You never left your mommy.
No.
How do you feel about her?
I love her.
You love her. Did you know Michael from a different life? Did you know each other?
No.
Why did you pick your mommy?
Because she was so shiny.
Mm-hmm.
So shiny, like a star. She still loves me.
She, of course she loves you. She'll always love you.
Mommy wants me to go. When she says to Belly, she has to lose to Belly. But she doesn't know.
Is that why? It's you? Are you ready to go to the light now, Michael?
My mommy.
She's your mommy, but you can see her from the light, too. You can come back as a little angel, a little cherub. Would you like that? And then not worry about her having a big tummy. Could you like to do that?
Yes, but she doesn't want me to go.
All right, let's speak with her. Let's speak with her. Linda, do you realize that you've been holding this little Michael here for so long?
No.
Not allowing him to go to the light?
I didn't know.
Are you ready to let him go now? With love?
Oh my God, so much love I have for him.
Mm-hmm. Tell him what love you have for him.
My mommy loves you so much.
Mm-hmm.
You have to go with the angels.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to take you to a beautiful place with Amanda and Grammy. And Richie and Lee and everybody's there to greet you.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see mommy from up above.
Mm-hmm.
And you can feel mommy and whisper to mommy. Whisper to mommy's here whenever you want me. I hear you. Mm-hmm. I'll feel you. I'll know you're there.
Good. Let me talk to Michael now. Michael, are you ready to go?
Yes.
Okay. Pull all of your influence from inside of her. Let's pull it all out so she can have a nice flat tummy now. And go with the angels. The angels are waiting for you. Archangel Michael is going to take you. Don't cry, Michael. This is a happy thing. It's not goodbye. It's just so long. Okay?
I'm going to miss my mommy.
You will. You're going to be able to be with her.
Okay.
As a light.
I whisper to her.
Very
good. To her.
Very good. Thank you very much. Is there anything else there that we need to take care of today?
The left temple.
All right. The left hip.
Left temple.
Left temple. Let's find out what's there. Bring that energy down. Bring it down. Good evening.
Hi.
Who are you?
I'm a friend.
A friend. Why do you hang out in her temple?
Because Linda needs help.
What kind of help?
Sometimes she needs to think.
She needs to think?
She needs to think.
And who are you to...
And not be so ditzy.
Mm-hmm. And who are you that has the authority to make her think?
I help her.
Mm-hmm. In what way?
I give her a pain there when she's not doing the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
If she doesn't concentrate, if she doesn't follow through, if she procrastinates, or if she... I push her.
Mm-hmm. What's your name?
Andrea.
Andrea?
Yes.
Are you a woman or...?
Yes.
So, Andrea, did you ever have a life? Our own body?
Yes.
How old are you?
45.
45. And how did you lose your life?
I was shot.
In what? Where?
When I left school, I was a teacher.
Mm-hmm. Where'd they shoot you?
In my head.
Mm-hmm. Is that why you hang out in your temple?
In my left temple.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So you're just a school teacher who wants to be able to teach?
Yes.
Okay. Do you realize, Linda, that when one transitions out of their body, the natural progression and evolution is to go to the light? Did you know that?
I take Linda to get me.
Why didn't you go to the light?
Because Linda needed me. Her light called to me.
Ah, she called you?
Yes, her light did.
Mm-hmm. But you see, this is not your body. You already had one. The natural progression for a soul is to go back to the light where you can go back to school, where you could help, when you could become a guide.
I'd like that.
Yeah, I know you would. So let's talk with Linda, because she made an agreement with you. Linda, do you realize that you made a contract with this teacher?
No, I didn't.
Are you ready to break that contract? Go ahead and tell her it's okay to go.
It's okay to go, and thank you.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
All right. Okay, Andrea, you ready to leave now?
Yes.
All right. Go ahead and pull all of your influence from her head.
I have an apple for her.
Mm. Give her an apple.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. And let's have the angels take Andrea up to the light. May the light of the universe always accompany you, Andrea. Thank you. And now the higher self. Can you tell me if there's anything else influencing her? She spoke of issues with her body, high cholesterol.
The cholesterol is high, mm-hmm. but she lost a lot of weight.
Okay, so we can, you can continue working with her on that?
Yes.
All right, would you please do some adjustment today so that she can start getting it down even faster?
Yes.
Thank you. And would you tell her why she has fear of heights? What's going on there?
She fell.
She fell down.
Hi.
Is this from a different life?
Yes.
Go ahead and show her that life very quickly. Give her the image of that.
I was on a mountain.
On a mountain. Mm-hmm.
And I didn't see that it was the end.
Mm-hmm. So what happened in that mountain?
I fell off the cliff.
Mm-hmm.
I was following a bunny.
Mm-hmm. A bunny?
A bunny.
How old were you there?
I was young.
Mm-hmm. And you fell? Mm-hmm. All right. So do we need to have that fear anymore?
No.
All right. Can we see that this was just a mistake that she made? She doesn't have to keep reminding herself of that fear. She made a mistake following a bunny. She was just having fun. And we don't need to have that fear anymore. Very good. Very good. Is there anything else that I could have asked that I didn't ask today? Are we complete? Very good. Very good. Thank you so much for all the information you've given her today. Wide awake now, feeling wonderful all over.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
Immensely happy.
Immensely happy?
And at peace.
That's beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good cry, huh?
I felt it this
morning. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It was beautiful, huh?
Yes.
How long do you feel you're on this journey?
An hour.
2 hours.
2 hours?
Mm-hmm. 2 hours.
That flew by. How old was I above? Thank you for such big walls around me. I wasn't even letting in, but that's why when I meditate, mm-hmm. and to the, oh wow, I feel weak. And to, I just realized I don't have selenite. Wow, but I felt like I did. That was strange.
Mm.
I understand so much more now.
Mm-hmm.
My own walls that I put up.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm trying to break them without knowing that they're there. Trying to see past them.
Yeah.
Without knowing that I put them up.
Mm-hmm. And you tore them down now.
Yes, I feel so peaceful. I feel like I used to feel
mm-hmm.
when I was Linda. Mm-hmm. You know, before all the heartache and everything.
Oh, you're Linda again.
I feel
you did
her.
Great. You did fantastic.
Thank you. It was a little hard at first, and one thing you said that really stayed with me and helped me was the visions. Mm-hmm. I felt. I didn't see it as much.
You felt
as the knowing mm-hmm. and the hearing.
Mm-hmm.
And I would see, like I saw the green thing, which he was funny. Like he would just shake it up every once in a while.
A big jello, big green
yes,
jello?
Yes. Yeah, but he was like my rock, even though he was jello.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
And again.
You did great.
Thank you.
You did great.
Wow. That was beautiful, my brother.
So, would you want to share some of this?
I don't know. What do you think? It was a lot of fun.
It's up to you. I mean, a lot of it is personal.
Personal, yes.
A lot of it isn't. There's some parts that are not. So, mm-hmm. we can do the jello part.
Mm-hmm.
There's a few parts that are very interesting. We could talk about it.
Okay. Wow.
Good.
Yeah, this was amazing.
So, you want to?
Yes.
We're going to share some of this part?
Yes, we're going to share some of it. The earth. The mm-hmm. earth is very important now, but
mm-hmm.
because it was all about energy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There was no food, no, you know,
just
we
energy.
Didn't need any of that
no.
to survive. All we needed was each other.
Mm-hmm.
That was very important. That
yeah.
We were a unit, and each one was there for the next.
It was beautiful.
Right. So we just had a really way out there jello existence.
Amazing.
Amazing. So tell everybody what you were expecting and now how you feel.
I was okay. Have each one. It was nothing like I expected. It was going on a journey
mm-hmm.
that you are wide awake mm-hmm. right, and mm-hmm. sleeping. You're just speaking and feeling and seeing. And it was amazing what you have locked inside of you. It really is. You don't mm-hmm. you don't know until you experience this feeling, this lightness, feeling the energy, seeing beyond this dimension. Really. It was beautiful. I would definitely and I not only do I am, you will see me again now. This
so,
was beautiful.
So
we
have just had an experience here in Elizabeth, New Jersey, which is just across
the river
from New York. And where are you from?
Queens.
Queens. So yeah. That's right up the street here compared to Miami.
I was heading there. I was going to Miami. Yeah.
So if you would like a session with me, it's not going to be you probably won't be jello. But if you want a session with me, you can go to albaweinman.com and sign up. Easy.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Very
and
easy.
You can look me up and we'll see you sometime soon. So it was great. Until the next one.
Yes.
Bye.
Thank you.
Wonderful.